The Hoyas and the Orange renewing a great rivalry tonight at the Carrier Dome. Hey, how are you, folks? Jason Horwitz, glad to be with you on the College Basketball Preview Show, brought to you by the California Almond Board. Let's bring in our college basketball columnist, Gary Parrish, to break this down. And Gary, Syracuse, 5 straight wins against Georgetown at the Carrier Dome. But this week, you have the Hoyas in your top 10, the top 25-1. So this is a battle, in your eyes, of two top 10 teams. Just how close is Georgetown to Syracuse in your vision?
I think they're close. I mean, look, Syracuse is favored in this game, but that's because the game's at Syracuse. You play this game at Georgetown, Georgetown's probably favored. They're 4 or 5 points within each other, regardless, you know, on a neutral court, probably closer than that, honestly. So, it's fun because, you know, we just spent a Saturday of tremendous college basketball, and then here we are right here on a Monday night, ready to go again.
And it is a quick turnaround, and for Georgetown, what will be important, or at least help a little bit, is the fact that they blew out Rutgers, so some of their starters, because this is not a very deep Georgetown team, some of those starters got some rest at the end of that game, and so with a short turnaround, that could certainly help. I want to ask you about Syracuse, though, because Wesley Johnson, huge ball game against Marquette, 22-15, his 9th double-double, but they beat the Golden Eagles without a point from Andy Routens. What does he have to do in this ball game, and really for this team all season?
He's got to make shots. I mean, you can beat Marquette with Andy not making shots or not scoring a point. You can do that, but you can't beat Georgetown like that. If he struggles again against in a game like this, on this stage and against a caliber opponent of Georgetown, then Syracuse is going to have his hands full.
Well, what about for Georgetown in the backcourt here? Because you talk about the 2-3 zone. We're always going to talk about the length, and can you make three-pointers over it? Chris Wright, he's taking a turn, having a great game. Austin Freeman, the one against Connecticut a couple of weeks ago. Do you think they'll have that type of game here tonight?
Well, they shoot it well from back there. I mean, they're ranked 17th nationally in three-point percentage. Freeman shoots 46.3% from beyond the arc, Wright's at 41.7. So this is, you know, they're equipped to do it. I mean, they're making shots, and they've been doing it all year. And so if they go in there and make shots against that zone, then they're in good shape. I mean, you know, Greg Monroe's been really good lately, but he's not necessarily the key. If they can make shots, they haven't. I'll put it this way. When they've made shots this year, they haven't lost.
That's a solid point. And certainly with Greg Monroe, who's been on a tear the last three games, 21 points or so in those three games. But, again, you're going to have to make shots, going to have to battle a long 2-3 zone, which is something that Syracuse has more this year than in years past in terms of length on the outside. Gary, what do you think the key will be tonight's matchup and who wins it?
I think it is making those shots. I mean, like I said, Monroe went for 29-16 at Villanova. You can't do much better than that, and the Hoyas still lost. But here's this. In all three losses, they shot below 34% from three-point range. They shoot above 40 on the season. So whenever they've shot the way they usually shoot, they've won. When they haven't, when they've dipped, is when they've lost. So that's the key. You know, they have to shoot it well. Even if Monroe is – they can win with Monroe being bad, and they can lose with Monroe being great. But what they can't do probably is win without shooting the ball well. That said, this game's at the Carrier Dome, and it's going to be, 30,000, 35,000 people. It's a tough place to go in and win, I think on this night. So, look, you put them on a neutral court, let's flip a coin. You put them at Georgetown, let's go Georgetown. Tonight at the Carrier Dome, I think Syracuse gets out of it with a win.
Yeah, expecting 32,000, and what they saw last year at the Carrier Dome with 31,000 people was a 98-94 overtime game. We'll see what happens in this one. Gary, thank you very much, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, guys.
All right, folks, for more on this ball game, keep it right here with CBSSports.com. And don't forget the College Basketball Preview Show, brought to you by the California Almond Board. Become a pro snacker with a handful of California almonds this season. For Gary Parrish, I'm Jason Horwitz. Take care, folks.